In a 1990 Ask Marilyn column, a reader asked this simple probability puzzle. Marilyn gave the correct answer, and then around 10,000 readers wrote in saying that she was wrong, including many mathematicians. More recently, researchers tested humans and pigeons to see how well they perform playing this game. And, well, the pigeons won. Let's explore this Monty Hall problem in five levels, ranging from simulations to a thorough solution with conditional probabilities. You are a contestant on a game show. There are three doors. Behind one door is a new car, and behind the other two doors are goats or other gag prizes. You won't win anything by selecting these. The car is equally likely to be behind each of the three doors, but you don't know which it is. First, you select a door. Then the game show host opens one of the other two doors, and the host will always open a door with a goat behind it. Now you have a final choice to make. You can stay with the door that you picked initially, or you can switch to the other door. If you choose the door with the prize, then you win. So the question is it to your advantage to switch? Marilyn argued that it is in your favor to switch, and you'll have a 2/3 probability of winning the car. Most of the 10,000 letters that the magazine received claimed that the probability is 1/2 for each of the two remaining doors, so it really doesn't matter if you switch or not. So let's start with some simulations. Here are the results of some simulations that I ran, which track how many times staying or switching was the winning strategy. We see that the switching strategy wins approximately twice as often. For level two, let's answer this puzzle mathematically with the so-called simple solution. For this level, let's assume that you decide the day before if you're going to stay with your initial door or switch. The car is behind door 1, 2, or 3, each with probability 1/3. This is our sample space, all the possible outcomes for our random experiment. Let's call the door that you pick door number 1. Let's start with the strategy of staying with your original door, meaning that you will end up with door 1 at the end of the game. If the prize really is behind door 1, then you win. But if the prize is behind door 2 or 3, then you will lose. So you have a 1/3 probability of winning the game. Now, what if you switch doors? If the prize is behind door 1, then the host will open either door 2 or 3, and you'll switch to the other one, so you'll lose. If the prize is behind door 2, then the host is forced to open door 3, you'll switch to door 2 and win. If the prize is behind door 3, then the host must open door 2. So when you switch to door 3, you'll win the game. There's a 2/3 probability that you win, and Marilyn was right. For level 3, let's look at the 10 doors variation. Now there are 10 doors to pick from, each equally likely to have the car. The other 9 doors all have goats. You pick a door, and then the host will open 8 doors, all of which are goats. There are 2 doors remaining, and you can stay with your original door or switch. Let's call the door that you picked door number 1. If you decide to stay with door number 1, then the only way you can win is if the prize is behind door number 1. That has probability 1/10. But what if you switch? Let's say the prize is behind any door from 2 through 10. The host must open 8 out of those 9 doors. Since one of them has the car, the host must open the 8 with goats, leaving only one door with the car behind. If we switch doors, we'll switch to that door with the car and win the game. So there's a 9 out of 10 chance that we'll win by switching. I think this variation is a great way to soften that incorrect assumption that staying and switching have the same probability of winning. For level 4, let's explore another variation that can help us gain a deeper understanding. We again have 3 doors, but this time each door has a separate probability of having the prize. Say we label the doors so that door 1 has the highest chance of having the car and door 3 has the lowest chance. Let's call those probabilities P1, which is greater than or equal to P2, which is greater than or equal to P3. These 3 probabilities add up to 1 since the car has to be behind exactly one of those doors. So what's the optimal strategy now? You can pause here if you want to think about it. Since the doors now have different probabilities, it matters which door we initially pick. Say we start with door 1. Then we can either stay with door 1 or we can switch. If we stay with door 1, the only way to win is if the car's behind door 1, which has probability P1. But if we switch, then we'll win in the other two cases with probability P2 plus P3. So the optimal strategy is actually to start by picking door 3, the one that is least likely to have the car. And then by switching, we win if either door 1 or 2 have the car with probability P1 plus P2. For level 5, let's return to the standard Monty Hall problem with 3 doors that are each equally likely to have the prize. But this time, we'll do a more thorough analysis. Let's find the probability of winning conditioned on which door the host opens. We'll also consider the host's behavior. After we pick our initial door, the host usually has only one possible choice of which door to open, because he always has to open a door with a goat. But if we happen to pick the correct door initially, then the host actually has a choice to make, and there's no guarantee that he'll make that choice equally likely. Let's call the door that we initially pick door 1. If door 1 actually has the car, then the host has a choice to make. Let's say in this case he picks door 2 with probability P, and he'll open door 3 the rest of the time with probability 1 minus P. P can be any value between 0 and 1 inclusive, so we can even consider the case where the host is guaranteed to pick a certain door. So we pick door 1, and then the host opens either door 2 or 3. Let's draw a probability tree. First, the prize is behind door 1, 2, or 3, each with probability 1/3. If the prize is behind door 1, then the host has a probability P of opening door 2 and probability 1 minus P of opening door 3. Multiplying the probabilities along each step gives us the probabilities of these two possible outcomes. There's a 1/3 P probability that the prize is behind door 1 and the host opens door 2. There's a 1/3 1 minus P probability that the prize is behind door 1 and the host has opened door 3. For the next branch, the prize is behind door 2, and in this case, the host must open door 3 to get a goat. So there's only one possibility that the prize is behind door 2 and the host has opened door 3, and this happens with probability 1/3. The last branch is similar, where the prize is behind door 3 and the host must open door 2. Now we can calculate the conditional probability of winning. Let's start with the strategy of staying with door 1 and find the probability of winning given that the host opens door 2. When we look at the probability tree, there are two outcomes that match this situation. Either the prize is behind door 1 or door 3, the first and the last leaves of the tree. If the prize is behind door 1, then we win. If instead the prize is behind door 3, then we lose. Bayes' theorem gives us a formula to calculate the conditional probability of winning. We add up the probabilities of the cases where we win, 1/3 p, and then divide by the total probability of these cases, 1/3 p plus 1/3. This simplifies to p over p plus 1. Let's repeat the calculation, this time conditioning on door 3 being opened. This time we consider these two branches. We'll win if the car is behind door 1. Applying Bayes' theorem, we get the conditional probability of winning is 1/3 1 minus p divided by 1/3 1 minus p plus 1/3, which simplifies to 1 minus p over 2 minus p. To see which strategy is better, we can repeat these calculations for the strategy where we switch to the other door. If door 2 is opened and we switch, we're in one of these two cases. This time, we win if the prize is behind door 3. We get the conditional probability of winning is 1/3 divided by 1/3 p plus 1/3, which simplifies to 1 over p plus 1. Lastly, let's condition on door 3 being opened. Now the conditional probability of winning simplifies to 1 over 2 minus p. So which strategy is best? If door 2 was opened, then our conditional probabilities of winning are p over p plus 1 if we stay, and 1 over p plus 1 if we switch. The denominators match, so we can just compare the numerators. 1 is always at least as big as p, so it's at least as good to switch doors in this case. If door 3 was opened, then the conditional probabilities of winning are 1 minus p over 2 minus p if we stay, and 1 over 2 minus p if we switch. Again, the denominators match, so we can just compare the numerators. 1 minus p must be between 0 and 1, and 1 is always at least as good as 1 minus p. In each case, switching is at least as good as staying, and in at least one of those two cases, switching is a strictly better strategy. One final thing, we can use the law of total probability to check that the overall chance of winning if we switch is 2/3. We write the probability of winning as the probability that door 2 is opened times the probability that we win conditioned on door 2 being opened. Then we add the probability that door 3 is opened times the conditional probability of winning in that case. We can find the probability that door 2 is opened from our probability tree. It's 1/3 p plus 1/3. Similarly, we can find the probability that door 3 is opened, and the conditional probabilities we already found before. So combining all this together, we get that the overall probability of winning if we switch doors is 2/3. I think the Monty Hall problem shows us how counterintuitive conditional probabilities can be, at least until we get some practice with them. Do you have another way to solve this problem or know of another variation? Let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.